Here's one of our favorite singers singing a song that he wrote about one of our favorite dancers.
Yeah.
Get hold of the DVD for the Joe Cocker, Leon Russell, Mad Dogs, and Englishmen movie. Watch it dance.
There's a lady I know.
Sweet Emily.
And I'm lucky to say she's a woman in every way. Cause she weeps just like a widow when her hate is clouding up my day. Touches my eyes, she takes my heart in her hand. If you knew that child, you'd plainly see. When she laughs, I'll realize
I'm in love with my sweet Emily. That's what I'm talking about.
She tell me what is jiving when it's real.
She tell me what is jiving when it's real.
She's a dancing delight.
See there, she's a dancing delight.
Feel good. If I need forgive I'm lost,
well,
I know she would.
I know she would.
Just the one in the world. And it's a natural fact. She can put me right back on the right track.
Tell me about the experience of hearing Sweet Emily the song the first time.
It just embarrassed me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Miss Emily Smith discusses her song. She is sweet indeed. Tell me about it.
Well, okay, he's been working on it for a couple of days in Muscle Shoals.
Yeah.
But just the music track part.
He cut that track in Muscle Shoals. Is that what
the
you're saying?
The musical part. Yeah,
yeah,
I guess
sure.
The whole thing was cut there, right.
That's cool.
Okay, and so he's been working on the music track, and he was working on something for Ray Charles was the plan.
Yeah.
So he's working on something for Ray Charles, and he pretty much gets all the soundtrack right. Well, then I do one of my power nap things. Come to, and he's written that horse on there.
Well,
I was horrified.
Well,
Ripley, I was horrified. I said, I doubt Ray Charles will be singing a better. Now, that name is popular now. You got to realize 30 years ago, there was maybe three people named Emily on the planet. One of them, Emily Dickinson, was one of them, and it was just a completely white little, God, it is. So, I mean, I was just horrified. I'm not flattered by that. I'm just embarrassed. Oh, Rita Coolidge was my favorite. She just had a little busted gut fit over it. She came blowing in the house with Booker T, who her sister lived with out at 7709 Sky Hill. And she came busting in Sky Hill Drive and snarling, said, "Why, you got it made." My dad, look, I beg your pardon. We all wasn't there. She'd come in. Oh, to show Booker T his studio, I guess, or whatever, thinking that he'd be there.
Yeah.
I guess he's got a name.
It was a momentary little tiny fit of jealousy, was it?
Yes.
That's so cute.
Yes, wasn't it cute? I guess she thought whatever hers was, and what's that Delta lady, shaming wet and naked in the garden. She would have rather had it be Rita standing, sweet Rita standing wet and naked in the garden.
Oh, that's great.
And so, Charlie, you got a maid? And I said, what, dinner?
Tell you where your heart is. But if you look in my eyes,